this is Tripp sitting back in the driver's seat. So we're going to have Cineboo 242, not Cineboard 262, my bad. We're going to have Cineboo versus MJG, and we're going to have Villager versus Sheik here. Excellent forward air chain. This is going to be a very patient match. Both these characters have excellent projectile games. Sheik having the best one of needles, or one of the best ones in needles. And Villager, his whole kit is projectiles. So good there on shield, unfortunately unsafe. Cineboo is abusing Sheik's crouch. That's something that I noticed that he's really good at currently. As any character who has stuff he can crouch, he's gonna sit out under that move. Excellent ledge pressure goes to the down throw into vanish. That's gonna be sealing that stock out less than a minute of the game, and only 25% on his first stock. MJG. Feeling a little flustered right now. As he gets lapped in percent, although he takes the lead right back. Yo, it's an outer shield footstool is there. Let's go. Yo, he's got these footstools outer shield. I think he's looking for like a triple turnip spike. So he can get like a reset on it. Actually, yeah. That would be untackable if he reset it. Yo, find that F tilt to up air. Forward throw, unfortunately not going to find a fair. It's a B reverse needles, unfortunately not going to find a follow up off him. MJG was looking for an up smash as he is still down over 100%. And only has a very small amount of percent before he is in kill percent. That down tilt staying on the ledge too long. And that DI mix-up on the cross-up on the up air, that's going to be sealing out that first game. Cineboo going to go up 1-0 here in winner's finals. Answering the chat's question of Case is actually Kansas. I believe he's Central Kansas PR. Alright, so we have a switch to Diddy Kong. We saw this come out, I believe, against Dare to Dream. I would say that it performed admirably. It got the win, so I mean, you really can't complain. So, that's gonna be Cineboo. On FD here, typically known as a pretty chic stage. However, Sheik can occasionally have problems landing. Wow. Went for a ledge jump, unfortunately not able to find it. So I think St. Louis, playing against St. Louis, has conditioned Cineboo to jab after his forward air, because apparently fair on shield is not safe. If you jab afterwards. So, we conditioned Cineboo into not getting greedy. Shout out to STL having Sheiks who do not jab after their forward. So, about 100% on each character here. Unfortunately, Sheik is going to have to find a very specific skill set up to find the kill here, where he can come down tilt. Or mana, of course. Going for an angel drop setup. Got the popping that he was missing quite a few times in the Dare to Dream setup. I saw this Diddy. Finds the up air or up throw. Unfortunately, he's going to trade, I believe, fair with that up air. Got a down tilt, not able to convert it into anything. No banana. Finds forward throw. And bouncing fish. And we have a DBZ moment here as fair was traded with bouncing fish. Both these characters at above 130. Last hit here, Sheik does find a grab, which unfortunately is not a grab, which is not a hit. 430 yet again. Now I'm gonna catch him sleeping out here. Ooh! Wow, that was a drag down up air into down smash. That's sealing out that stock, and MJG immediately evens up the stock with a run up and up smash. So 3 minutes 30 seconds into this game 2. And we are even up at, oh no, an SD from Cindy Boo. That was needles in the air, and I believe that was 60 up B. So. No, that's not yours. I saw it was leaking, and it's on the power strip.
Hey, yo, shout out to our boy 8Ounce on the Melee stream.
Yeah. Our boy 8Ounce. Yeah. Yo, 8Ounce is on commentary, yo.
Yeah.
Yo, let's go. I don't know whose water this is, but it's mine now.
All right, we're game around. Winners finals. Cindy Boo versus MJG.
Yeah, so unfortunately, they were even Steven here on FB here. And Cindy Boo SD'd at sub 10%.
Womp womp.
So, he SD'd real early in the game too, where I think he's going to bring it back. Who's that? Oh yeah, I can totally still win here. So, not like that, this is a pretty good stage for, King in general, because he can just throw needles.
Yep.
So, good monkey flip by MJG. That was not a good monkey flip. Sorry, I'm enjoying some of this tasty agua. Finds an up throw to back air, of course. Diddy Kong has pretty much limitless combo potential out of his up throw, where Sheik has limitless combo potential, period. Full stop. Out of everything. Excellent spacing on that. Finds the perfect pivot. Unfortunately, not going to get the bouncing because he wanted. Instead, gets grenade.
At least it wasn't off stage.
Yeah. That's going to be a forward throw. Unfortunately, lands on the mana. He's still finding fair to still keep these on stage. Nice. Needle. Sends him back off stage. Bouncing fish not going to connect. And Cindy Boo holding the banana. Ooh, got the Z drop banana. I think he's trying to convert that into something. Unfortunately, not able to find it.
MJG being real, real conservative here.
Ooh, not finding that air dodge. Maybe thinking that Cindy Boo is going to wait on that as he has.
Got the banana, the down tilt conversion into the up smash.
Yep. So,
hot damn.
So, bread and butter Diddy conversion finding out here, but. Diddy, of course, having a great neutral, really easy to find those kill confirms. But Cindy Boo is out here, man. He's got 39% right there.
Yep. Cindy Boo looking pretty good.
Good back throw. Oh, that was with
the eye. Got it the second time around, though.
Good barrel, Diddy. Great.
I can never hit with those.
I always just blow up on the stage.
Yeah.
That's why I don't play this game. Good monkey flip kick. Unfortunately, that banana had already been used once and he didn't notice.
Good back air.
Yeah, good job even recognizing an option there.
Yeah.
So that was, he actually read his buffered option there. Oh, wow. Great perfect hit and grab. Gets nice up pummels.
Once again, MDG being real conservative. I think he's scared.
I mean, he's in kill percent.
Yeah, I think he's nervous. This definitely feels like a, what do I do kind of thing. Oh,
wow. Huge stage spike. Oh. And that is going to seal out that game. We're going to go 2-1, or 2-1 Cindy Boo over MJG so far in this best of 5. Do commentary right now.
Oh. I would like to do commentary.
Okay.
I'll do comments after.
All right. So, game 4 here, going back to FD.
Whose choice is that?
I actually don't know if they can. I think I can, but DSR means he, yeah, whatever. 43%, Tinibu opening this one off with a bang. Top tier privilege getting him out of that F-tilt string. As he just kind of ducked.
Oh, that was a good swing.
That was a good edge cancel right there. And,
oh, I really thought he was going to trip on that banana.
Yeah, so we have, both these characters just trading shots here. And every time they'll open, like, they'll open each other up with a combo, then, they'll just, the other one will get another combo to open this one back up. However, Tinibu looking for that vanish kill, like, really early. He's already done it once this set, so probably went for it again. But,
The score is actually 2-1, correct?
Yes, it is actually 2-1. Nice Baron to grab, finding that low percent guaranteed damage after finding that kill. Tinibu. Oh wow. Excellent job. Oh, he didn't even get up after that trip.
Yep.
Realizing that Diddy Fair is actually not unpunishable, runs in and grabs it and throws him off stage for it. Excellent pivot grabs him off stage. Okay.
Tinibu doing good. Was that some mind games?
No, no. He SD'd like that game 2 and died.
Oh, okay.
So
I see.
And that's how he lost game 2. So
right.
Yeah, definitely not mind games. I think he's trying to do like universal kill stuff.
Oh.
And unfortunately, he's gonna eat an up smash for slipping on a banana. But I think he's just trying to get like he's very technical and like he's a very technical player.
Right.
And sometimes he flubs.
Here we go. Diddy Kong and Sheik.
You know, for the fourth game in a row.
Yeah.
Third game in a row. I mean, it's interesting to notice that well, all of their Diddy Kong and Sheik games have been on FD, so. And they didn't have one Lilac game with Villager involved, but I believe. No, I think it was Smash Bros. There's a lot of Villager.
MJG. Closing that gap.
Yeah, brought it right back.
Yeah.
Of course, Diddy Kong does have a very high damage output. It's just typically, it's like, oh man, one neutral win, 20%, one neutral win, 20%. And he's finding these two wins and has brought it back to pretty much an even game. One smash attack will pretty much even this up, if not kill him.
He was trying to find that banana.
Something I think that Diddy Kong is pretty unique for Diddy Kong is that he actually kills his smash attacks. Like,
yeah.
He has kill confirms into his smash attacks, which is pretty rare. Something
this
I kinda
game,
like
this
that.
Game especially, yeah.
Like, you got
box. I guess any of them.
Yeah, you can like box like down, like landing down air up smash, but like
Diddy holds him for a while. Perfect.
Yeah. And like he gets like jab up smashes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like, so up throw, goes for the 50-50 and gets the air dodge. Unfortunately not gonna not being rewarded for 50.
105
to 138. It went through the
needles. Oh, and Diddy comes back.
Yeah. Diddy Kong does have great distance space recovery. I thought he was just gonna go out there and air. So he's actually using back throw. It's gonna seal out that
did it.
Stock. And
woohoo! The winner is Diddy Kong. If MJG wins, is this winner's grands after that?
Yeah, it'd be winner's.
So these
players are guaranteed top three. These guys are playing for grand finals winner's side here.
We're in top eight.
All right, so we're going to Smashville, otherwise known as Sheikville. and we're going to see KK Slider coming out to play tonight. Of course, he's not actually playing, but I'm sure if you guys are listening to the music, he is there. Oh, so clean. Goes back here. Offstage gets the jab. Unfortunately, not able to get a conversion off of it. Oh. I'll try to get F tilt to grab. Unfortunately, it was not the percent range for it.
See, once again, it looks like MJG just gets the download on these characters and purposefully plays the long game in order to, like, really hammer out these wins. Really trying to figure out his opponent, you know?
Yeah. Sinibu is doing a great job of, like, reading his option selects as well. So, like, it's not like there's definitely adaptation on both sides going on.
Oh. Yeah, but MGG really just bringing it back. Sinibu is
that's super dead. You can't mess around on the Smash Hill platform. Especially with a character with great back throw.
Looks like this is going to be called Diddyville soon.
Jab coming out.
Alright, let's go, Diddy. Back up on the platform. Looks like he didn't learn from the first time. Oh, and now he's at 36%.
Yeah. So, the forward throw. Tries to get a bouncy fish. Gets a stage spike. Off stage. He's real low and he's going to die.
He's gone.
So, great job by Sinibu eating this thing up. Right now, he's got his banana on the ground right now. It's mine.
Sinibu. Ugh. Trying to get in there, but MJG's just not letting him through.
Yo, Diddy Kong definitely has some pressure tools and neutral. Man, you know what's really nuts? As I'm sure you guys can't hear this, but every time these guys get grabbed, I can hear them mashing. It's like incredibly quick. And these guys are serious about not wanting to be in grabs. So.
Oh.
There's a re-grab there. Unfortunately, not gonna get the fair to grab. This is the fair to confirm that.
Diddy. Gaining some more percent.
And it's done! And that's a great pop up.
Solid pop off there by Sinibu. Good game.
He's gonna be moving on to winner's side grand finals. And the match we have coming up next is the STL Showdown. We have Drisson versus Fi.